Hey everyone, it's Yaz Espez.
And I'm Noelle, and my channel is Love for Makeup 22.
Today what we're going to be doing pretty much is health and weight loss. Okay, you guys have all wanted to know, how did I lose my 30 pounds? And Noelle, what was your situation that you have to like control your diet?
Basically, high cholesterol runs in my family, so I really like watching what I eat and how I diet and basically just my lifestyle and going to the gym and everything. Okay. For now, we just wanted to give you some pointers and, you know, how we maintain our weight and how we try to stay healthy.
So first we're going to start off with exercise routine is, but my pretty much routine is going to the gym, getting like a 7-minute cardio workout just to like increase the heart rate and whatnot. And then we're going to go down to machines, you know, get some, work our muscles out. You know, we're going to talk about different, I guess, exercises you could do, but pretty much go to the weights, and then go back to cardio for half an hour. So, what about you?
No, so I think what I've seen, what's really important is that you don't have to really, you know, work out every single day to an extreme. It's just important to work out a little bit every single day just to get some cardio, just to get your blood flowing, oxygen to your brain, and just, you know, basically...
No, you're right.
Basically, I just think it's important that you get some sort of exercise in just to stay healthy.
Yeah, so... Okay, so like you said, you don't have to go to the gym every day, but it's really good to get at least 30 minutes of cardio, either at least 3 times a week. You know, the more the merrier. You know, the more it'll help your and benefit your health.
Right, and depending on your lifestyle, if you work or if you're in school like we are, you know, if you're constantly sitting, you definitely want to get up and go for a quick run or something just to get your body moving so that you're not sitting the whole entire day and
exactly.
So you're doing something good for your body.
Exactly.
Point number two, basically the most important thing, drink lots of water.
This should be your best friend, okay? Water is going to be the best thing to keep your body running, to flush out the most, you know, people think that when you drink lots of water, you're going to have all that extra water weight on you, but in reality, drinking more water will help you lose that water weight, you know, because... when your body needs water, it stores that water weight instead of, you know, just, I guess, processing it through your body, you know what I mean? So drinking more water will help you lose that extra water weight that you're just carrying on weight-wise. And it's just good for your health. You need water.
Right. Yeah, it's definitely good to flush out your system, you know, and constantly, when I constantly drink throughout the day, I'm also not hungry all the time because I'm constantly filling up my body. You know, obviously you need to eat, but drinking a lot of fluids can really help maintain your weight.
Exactly, and it's also great for your skin. A lot of you have been asking me, what do I do to, you know, what do we do to keep having flawless skin, you know? And hydrating and drinking lots of water does help as well. Don't drink Coke or any of those sort of drinks that contain so much sugar, and it's not good for your health, so you should stay away from it.
Exactly, like try to stay away from sugary drinks. Even juices, you can drink juices, but they contain so much sugar, so water is definitely the way to go.
Water. Next what we'll be talking about is smaller portion meals.
Basically, I think the way to eat, you know, I've heard it a lot, is when you're hungry, you tend to just stuff yourself and eat to the max. And what's important is that, you know, when you eat, try to eat in a small portion and wait 20 minutes after you eat and see if you're full, because usually your body doesn't, or your mind doesn't really realize you're full until 20 minutes after you ate. So try to eat in small portions if you can, and that way, oh, and more frequently throughout the day.
Okay, well, sorry for that interruption. Okay, so like she said, smaller portion meals is key. Over here, I brought an example of what I would probably eat in the morning. This is my little container, and it contains oatmeal.
And it smells so yummy. I can smell it from here.
Yeah, so this I've made on my own, and it's not packaged or anything like that. You get straight up oatmeal, the oatmeal grains. Is that what they call it?
Just the raw oatmeal.
Raw oatmeal. I get half a cup. I put it in a glass bowl, and then I fill it with water. I don't even know how much water. Just fill it barely above the line of food, I guess. And what I do is I cook the oatmeal and then I add cinnamon. I add some raisins in there just to give it some natural sweetness. And what you can also do is add some sugar-free jelly, which will give it some flavor. You don't have to add sugar. Try to stay away from bad carbs. Oatmeal is a great source of carbs, you know? It's good.
Yeah, and it contains lots of fiber, which also helps your digestion. So it's great in that sense. And what I like to do is I like to sometimes use nuts and put some nuts in my oatmeal, like walnuts, because they're really good for you and it's brain food. So, you know, it's healthy for you and it makes your brain work better and kind of fills you up a little bit more.
That's really good. I suggest nuts as well.
Okay.
You know, another thing that you can eat in the morning, which is great, is egg whites. I recommend it to anyone. It's one of the cleanest forms of... It's one of the cleanest forms of protein that you can have, and so yeah. All right, so yes, we've had to change locations, but it's okay. We left off talking about protein. A really good source of protein needs to be in your diet, and the cleanest ways that you can eat the protein is eating egg whites, chicken breast, or fish. These are the three ways that, or there's even more, you know, shrimp, but like straight up protein is great because it's able to pretty much give you zero fat. You know, there's no fat in those unless you, of course, cook it with, you know, extra butter and all that stuff.
And try to use olive oil because olive oil is a good kind of fat. And
so that's really good. Next, what I wanted to show you guys was pretty much what can you eat during the day. A lot of you guys say, or even when you get your sweet tooth, you know, like, oh my god, I'm craving something sweet, and it's just, I need to have some chocolate or something. I mean, I'm bad, and I'll probably have like a piece of chocolate or something, but what is a good thing to do? Because I know what I'm doing isn't right.
So basically, I have a really big sweet tooth as well, and I always crave chocolate, things like that. So what I've been trying to do, and it's really helped me, is buy foods like papaya or, you know, honeydew melon, something like that, something that's really filling. And it's sweet, and when you eat that, or grapes are really good too, because when I eat those fruits, I'm filled, pretty much filled, and then I have less of a craving. I still have a little bit of a craving, and it's good to have, you know, a treat of chocolate or something, kind of to treat yourself, but try not to sit there and eat a whole bar of chocolate. Try to opt for fruit instead.
Yes. Yeah, and some really good fruits that are great for your digestion are, you know, pineapple is also really good. What else is good? I mean, I don't know if oranges might have a lot of sugar, but I love oranges.
Vitamins.
And it's got vitamin C, and, you know, which leads to another point. Vitamins are super important to take. Like, you need your vitamin C, vitamin D, you know, your vitamin, you know, B12. Like, all these things are really important for your daily, you know, health and to maintain a healthy lifestyle.
Yeah, and just also for brain function, you know, you want to function well during the day. You don't want to be sleeping tired. You want to take your vitamins to pretty much be awake and alert and just be healthy overall. So if you, you know, don't have that healthy diet, then you want to definitely opt for some natural, vitamin supplements.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, taking those like once a day can really help your diet.
For sure. What are some things that you do when you're at the gym? Like, what's your daily routine for that?
Basically, what I think is most important is to focus on cardio. First, focus on cardio because you really want to break a sweat, and you really want to, you know, focus on cardio because a lot of people just use weights, and if you only use weights, then you're just toning. You're just getting muscle and not really getting rid of any fat. So you really want to get your blood flowing and really get a good, you know, cardio workout in before you do some, you know, toning and shaping up with some muscle work.
And I agree. And when you're doing cardio, it's not like you have to be running 100 miles an hour. You know, I couldn't even do Stairmaster for 2 minutes, you know, when I first started, I swear. And the best thing for you to do really is go on an incline. On the treadmill, go on incline maybe 10. If you could do, incline 10 and the speed like around 3.6, 3.7, and just, you know, start walking, move your whole body. It's going to be great to, number one, build muscle, reduce the fat, and it's going to be great for your cardio workout.
It's really important to build up your endurance. Like, what
exactly.
I used to do is I used to go on the treadmill at like 6 miles per hour and I would be dead after 5 minutes. And, you know, it's important to just run at a low speed and try to run longer as opposed to faster and build up your endurance.
Exactly. Because nobody's going to be running, you know, a mile in 5 minutes. Well, I sure can't. Working out is going to be toning all at once. You can't be saying, oh, I want to focus on my legs only, or I want to focus on my arms only. Like, when you're losing weight and when you're in that process of losing the weight, your whole body has to be worked out, and you want to lose it all together. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and definitely what I think is important, you know, if you want to start working out and have a healthy lifestyle, you want to set a motivational goal for yourself. So maybe, you know, this might sound crazy to you, but maybe sign up for like a 5K run, which isn't actually that much. 5K is like 3.3 miles, I want to say, and it's not that much, and you have a lot of time to do it. You can walk. It's just to set a goal for yourself, just so you can start working out, because I feel like sometimes I go to the gym and I don't really have a motivational goal. I have nothing really to work out for. I'm like, oh God, I just want to go home. So, you know, try to set a goal for yourself and really try to focus on it. Maybe have like a planner and plan everything out. How much do you want to achieve per week or per month, and try to really focus on
and
that.
And another thing, usually people say, oh, I want to go to the gym, but I don't have the motivation. She's talking about motivation. Even if there's no one to go to the gym with, even though it's more motivational, once you get out of the house, I think the hardest part is getting out of the house, because once you're at the gym, you're motivated because everyone around you is working out, everyone is lifting weights, you know. And I can tell you, my toughest thing is getting me out of the house, you know, because it's just comfortable on the couch or whatever. But, you know, once you're at the gym, you're motivated and you go hard.
So we just wanted to give you guys kind of an overview of what we do to try to stay in shape and try to stay healthy, most of all, you know, what we do for our diet and exercise. And
exactly. Hopefully in the future, we'll give you more, you know, more exercise that you can do. You know, we gave you pretty much a basic breakdown of what you can do to get started, and you should try to cut out, you know, the sugars, try to cut out the bad carbohydrates, you know, which is white rice, white pasta. You know, you need to go with wheat, go with brown rice. You can eat brown rice, brown pasta, or wheat pasta, mm-hmm. and what else is, you know, all those things are great for you, or better for you if you're craving carbs, you know what I mean? Wheat bread, and you know, some snacks that we take to school would be what? I've seen you bring in carrots.
Yeah, like, you know, carrots. Try to bring raw vegetables. I mean,
so delicious, and it's healthy for you.
Yeah.
And another thing that's great is sweet potato. I know people say it's weird, or what am I doing eating a sweet potato in a bag? But, you know, like, who cares what others have to say? You know, like, you're fixing yourself, you're getting yourself healthy. Whatever it takes, you have to do it, you know what I mean? So, yeah, either boil a sweet potato, and it's going to be soft inside, it's sweet, it's delicious, and just put it in a bag and take it to go, and that'll be your snack for the day. And you know, carrots, vegetables, if you're craving something sweet, like she said, fruits, but all those are so much better for you than chocolate bar or candy. So
yeah,
hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you want more, you know, please write on our comment box. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Yaz the Spaz, and Noelle's channel.
And we'll link our channel names below so that you can see
below.
And go check them out if you like, and let us know, you know, if you want to hear more of some exercising or health tips.
Yeah. Also, you can also go to my blog and check out my weight loss story. I'm going to post the link down below as well. It's how I went from losing 30 pounds. I was 30 pounds heavier than I am now, and it was a struggle, but it was a great success, and I feel healthier than ever. So don't forget, everything's going to be below this video, and hopefully you enjoyed it, and
bye.
Okay, and a lot of you have been asking me, what do I wear to the gym? I know you guys say, oh, do you go to a women's gym? Do you go to a male's, both sexes gym? And I actually go to a gym that has both male and females, so yes, you have to cover more, and don't let that be an excuse not to go to the gym, because there's always ways of covering up. This is my way of covering up. I wear a long sleeve, similar to a turtleneck shirt, and I wear my cotton hijab, that is a square hijab that I fold in half like a triangle, and then I just tie it like a bandana, and this it absorbs whatever sweat, you know, is going to come down, and it feels, you know, it's refreshing, and it's just light, you know, because I know a lot of you guys are going to be sweating. And so this is what I'm wearing. Underneath I have, since the shirt is since the shirt is shorter, I wear a tank top underneath, as you can see. So it covers what needs to be covered. And I just wear it with some sweatpants. You know, you can go, you know, I don't know how else you'd like to do it, but you know, you can do it with sweatpants. You can do the long sleeve shirt underneath. You know, but I recommend covering your butt because there's men there, and you know, men are looking at everything, you know what I mean? So just, I guess, make sure you cover your butt and your chest. And usually what I wear is a sports bra, because that usually not only holds your body in place, but it's not revealing as if you're just wearing a normal bra, you know. And another thing that you guys can do just to get started is join the Naduna program. I'm going to post all her information below. This is their wristband that says, "I am Naduna Strong." Oh, by the way, do you like my ring? It's a dollar bill. No, but this program pretty much is, it's a women's health and fitness organization aimed at changing, you know, the world one calorie at a time. These women have goals of losing 5 to 10 pounds, even more, a month. And the founder of Naduna, her name is Nadine, and she actually has a goal of reaching 1,000 fans on Facebook, and then she's going to show her before and after pictures. And this, you guys, is a must see, because she has gone through a total transformation. If you think mine was through a total transformation, hers was even more. So definitely check her out. Her page is going to be down below. And she also sells these amazing gym clothes that you can wear at the gym, and I'm going to be showing you right now what they sell. And these are longer shirts with a hoodie, and they're absolutely amazing. This is what it looks like. Okay, as you can see, it's a zipped up shirt. It's very thin. It says Naduna. So it's got a little pink accent. And then what you can do is just wear it over your clothes. Oops. Don't mind me. Okay, so you wear it over whatever shirt you plan on wearing. And then you pretty much, it's long enough, it's thin, it's long, it's thin, and it covers what needs to be covered. You can zip it up, whatever. It's got pockets. It's perfect for going to the gym, and you even got the hoodie, so you get to be, and you get to be, you know, just rocking your hijab, rocking whatever. You know, everybody has different preferences, but yes, you should definitely join her Naduna program. They run across, you know, in different states, all across the U.S. So she's probably even been to your city if you haven't already heard about her. So go check her out. All her information is going to be below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channels. And until next time, keep it up. You know, you guys stay motivated. Check out my blog. You can see my before and after pictures. And I hope this is a great process for you all. And good luck. Assalamu alaikum. Okay, so we're going to begin now with the first pointer, and
the first pointer?
Okay, what's the first
pointer?
How we exercise.
Okay.
Just to, you know, maintain health.
Maintain healthy.
Yeah, to maintain being healthy.
Okay.
Oh,
eat smaller.
Wait till we defreeze. Okay, we're good.
Okay.
Okay, so let's move on to pointer number two.
Hang on.
Okay, let's
why see. Is it stuck?
Okay, let's wait till we pause.
Okay. Oh my god, I'm like, as if I'm praying.
Okay.
I just wanted to
preach.
Okay.
You know, because you want to tire out your muscles when you're in the, you know, with the weights, and then when you go to cardio,
you want to tire out your whole body.
Just get more tired.
You're just going to be dead.
Yeah, pretty much.